I thought I'd share with you a little tonight about a journey that the Holy Spirit's been taking me on, a little bit of that journey. I've been looking into coming into close relationship with God, and God's taught me about prayer and how important that is. So if it's okay, that's what I'll do. The Holy Spirit has been teaching me a lot about my relationship with God. He's made me realise that prayer and communication with God is as vital to my spiritual being as water is to my flesh. The Holy Spirit has led me on a study trail into the life of David, the boy who came a man after God's own heart. How lovely it would be to have that said about us. They were people after God's own heart. But how do we become that? So close to God, so aligned with him, that we know whatever happens, whatever situation we go into, that the miraculous is going to happen and that God will cover us. So as I looked at David, I wanted to know how I could become more like him, having this relationship where God's heart and mine could be one. David's relationship became close to God in the fields when he was watching the sheep. He sang songs to God. He spoke to God, and he was alone with God. Was the decision to have David shepherd those sheep his earthly father's alone? I don't believe so. I believe this was God's move. We are told God has planned our days, and it was all part of God's plan for David that he should become that shepherd. In that way, David would be able to draw close to God, and God would be come into relationship with him. This was the start of God showing David how much he loved him and he had a special plan for his life. David's own brother belittled him on the battleground just before he faced Goliath, saying, "What are you doing here? You go away and look after those few sheep you're in charge of." All they saw was someone that would get in the way. But by the time that David had reached the battlefield, he was no longer just who they saw on the outside. David was beginning to become that man after God's own heart. We are told David fought lions and bears and he experienced the supernatural. Think about it. A young man out on the fields, totally alone, looking after a herd of sheep and killing lions and bears. If that had happened to me and I was the one killing the lions and bears, I would know that it wasn't me that did that. I would know I had a supernatural help. No wonder David sang praises to God. And no wonder David said, "I'll go face Goliath," when mighty soldiers were afraid to go. We are told he didn't walk timidly up to Goliath, but he ran. 1 Samuel 17:48 says, "As the Philistine moved closer to attack him, David ran quickly into the battle line to meet him." Why? Because of the time spent alone with God in the fields with the sheep. He knew from past experiences that God would be with him. God had shown him he does not fight alone. David's faith was as strong as iron, and he had no fear. He knew God would give him the victory. David also came under attack when God started using him in a mighty way. He was targeted by the evil one. He came up against tragic circumstances. Later in life, after losing his son, David stopped mourning straight away after the death of his son and returned to worshipping God. We are told to expect opposition. We are told the devil is like a prowling lion ready to kill, steal, and destroy. A pastor I once heard explained this very well. He said, to understand this scripture, look at a lion in the natural. A lion will never attack a herd. It always waits for one to veer to the left or the right, to become isolated. As soon as that animal is isolated, then it is a victim. And not long after, the lion pounces and death occurs. That's why it's so important to stay close to your family, your church family. This is, so to speak, our herd. This is where we join together. We cover each other in prayer. We build each other up, encourage and support each other, and share testimonies of God's goodness and his presence in our lives. We are not here by chance. We have been placed here in safekeeping by God himself. What is it that that prowling lion is trying to kill? It's your faith. Once your faith is gone, just as the animal falls victim, so do we. All hope is gone, because if we lose faith, then what hope is there? It means that you are blinded to God, that life is what you get is what you see. And in this way, our hope is stolen and we are destroyed. So how do we become more like David? The Holy Spirit told me, we have to speak more to God, set time aside for him, bring him into every decision we make. God speaks to us all the time. Set time aside and really listen for his voice. Trust in his timing in answering our prayer. And remember, whatever the outcome of our situation, God is in control. When we face difficulties, mountains, the Bible tells us, we do as David did. We remember what God has brought us through already. We have all had battles. Every one of us here tonight has gone through something and come out the other side knowing that they wouldn't have come out as they did without God had been with them. These are our testimonies. These are faith builders for others as well as ourselves when we tell of them. And when the next battle comes before us, we stand firm in what God has already done and we are confident he will do again. And we learn, as David did, to trust when we step out. Our God will step out with us. Prayer is our way of coming closer to God. Our prayer life can be the one that comes under most attack. The devil doesn't mind how many good deeds we do or how often we come to church. But when we pray, that's a different issue. That's when the devil gets ruffled. And we'll try to do anything to divert our attention. Because as our prayers go up, then God himself reacts and spiritual battles take place. Our prayers stir the heavenly realm into action. Our prayers bring about miracles. Our prayers secure our victory. As David experienced when he went up against lions, bears, and eventually Goliath the giant, when we step out as a child of God, when our hearts become aligned with him, we no longer step out alone. God himself is with us. The Bible tells us, if God is for us, who can be against us? With God by our side, no matter what, the victory is ours. Amen.